Understanding Anger. Under this series, I will speak on these aspects, then on various aspects of the mind, and how meditation is the master of fire. There are certain elements in the cosmos. They are stable on their own. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. They are stable on their own, but when they form a group, the alliance can be stable, alliance can be unstable and volatile. When two molecules of hydrogen and one molecule of oxygen merge together in the presence of magnesium dioxide, it forms water, clear, crystal clear, life-giving substance. But when to this one more molecule of oxygen is added, it becomes H2O2. It is vicious in nature, unstable, and it is known as hydrogen peroxide. From this you can understand, as an individual, you are stable. But when you form an alliance with the next person, or with a spouse into matrimony, a lot is needed. Under normal circumstances and situation, the relation is stable. But then, when a particular element is added by one person, it becomes volatile. It becomes unstable. At that time, what is needed? Where Buddha's insight comes in. Be in the middle. Be in the middle means you are neither leaning to the left nor to the right. Instead, you are in the center. And being in the center means neutral. A volatile situation comes, your spouse gets angry, she adds a state of anger, she or he adds a state of anger, you counteract and the process becomes more and more volatile. At that time, being neutral is being in the middle. This requires tremendous understanding. In the absence of that, certain things develop in us. And that what develops is anger. And it becomes so volatile at times if it is not understood properly. I am not talking about managing anger. Managing anger means you are somehow trying to act. When you look at the movies, you realize in the movies it is all acting, whether Indian movies or anything. In the movie, the villain rapes the hero. Does he really do the act, or he is acting? He is performing his role according to the script. And the better he performs, his role is appreciated and he is given. His level of acting changes and he is given a different role in another movie. In the same way, life is a stage on which we come to act our part as father, mother, brother, sister, husband, wife. If we perform our role on this stage, deep down we know there is only oneness. Out of one, many was created. Out of one, this is what Tao begins. Lao Tse begins his Tao Te Ching with that understanding. In the beginning there is one. One got divided into 2, 3 thousands and millions. The process of meditation requires from many be moved to 2, 2, 1. One means we are one consolidated peace within, not divided over this and that. And then one of the deep understanding out of the scripture of self, Nanak explored deep within himself. And he said, Panch Parvan, Pancha Pavai, Dargayman, Pancha Kaguru Ekyan. Now, Panch, he is talking about 5. There are 5 organs of action and 5 organs of perception. Eyes bring the information through the image, ears bring the sound, the skin brings the touch, and so on and so forth. What is the faculty that coordinates the actions of all these 5? You are listening to this broadcast. What a sound comes to your mind. Sound reaches you through its own system of analog and digital. It reaches you. What confirms you that this is the voice of Tao Shabuddha? You are seeing an image, you are hearing a voice. There is something that coordinates the activities of all these organs of action and perception. Every sense organ brings its information and puts it in a particular place, in a lab. Facility. The eyes bring the image, the ears bring the sound. How the activities, how that information that has been brought by 2 different organs of action are to be coordinated. That which coordinates the activities of various sense organs and organs of perception. There are 2 things. One is perception and the other is action. You hear something and through the vocal cord you respond to it. So organ of perception and action. It is the meditation that coordinates the activities of various sense organs. You are seeing an image and you are hearing a sound, and something within tells you the person I am seeing and the person I am hearing are one. This is a process. For life to be in the middle, or steep, we have to understand anger. Anger is the outcome of ego and sex. Both sex and ego are the functions of the mind, and lack of understanding, this leads to a space of anger. And when there is a lack of understanding, a state of anger comes in. Without ignorance, ego ceases to exist. Without ignorance, ego ceases to exist. Just one moment, see anybody online. Without ignorance, ego ceases to exist. And without ego, ignorance and anger has no value, no use. In the process of inward journey, understanding anger is essential. Anger cannot be managed. In doing so, anger goes deep in subconscious level. There it is nourished and nurtured, suppressed by social norms, cultural values and traditions. Anger gains strength and momentum. Unwanted, it expresses itself even when the circumstances do not call for. Thus in the process of its evolution, anger goes on gaining momentum. It explodes like a force, like a bomb. As I said, when we add one more element, the two elements are associated with one another. This is what organic chemistry teaches us. And there is an imbalance. The association can be volatile, it can be stable, it can be explosive. When anger gains momentum, it brings with it fear, ignorance and violence to varying degrees. Fear is the outcome of ignorance. Ignorance is the ornament of ego. Fear is the outcome of ignorance, and ignorance is the ornament of ego. Together, these nourish and nurture anger. Without ignorance, ego ceases to exist, and without ego, ignorance and anger has no value, no use. Remember, when light of awareness and understanding descends, ignorance disappears in awe. And when ignorance disappears, ego vanishes. And with ego and ignorance vanishing, anger cannot surface. Thereafter, what remains is light of truth. Anger dissolves in that light. However, in the absence, despondency and agitation breeds in human mind. Filled with negativities, life full of anger goes on unabated. Because of unfulfilled desires, lack of understanding of sex energy and its transcendence, a process breaks in human mind, and anger is the outcome of this. And you continue to drown in the valley of darkness more and more. Anger is the downward movement of existential bioenergy. Let us look at a historic perspective. Jews tormented, suppressed, beaten Jesus to a degree that you cannot imagine. Many years ago, when one person made, I do not recall his last name, made a movie on Jesus, and it was very depressing to people. People did not like. But what Neil showed, what had happened to Jesus in the hands of Jews, is not even a percent of what actually Jesus has had to undergo in the hands of Jews. Jesus was a positive energy. Nature always balances. There has to be a balance between positive and negative energy. And that balance comes only through being in the middle, being neutral. At that point, that is, according to Bhagavad Gita, is known as no war zone. The two armies are away together as opposing forces, the negative and the positive, you may say, ready to fight. But in between there is a zone known as no war zone. That is the zone of neutrality. You have to discover that zone within your mind mechanism. And meditation is that process to discover that no war zone or zone of neutrality within you. Jesus was the positive energy, full of compassion. He could not react. He suffered all that humiliation, tormentation that he had to undergo in the hands of Jews. Now, history repeats itself. Later, many centuries after, energy was born in the form of Hitler. Hitler is the negative energy that complemented Jesus, and he was against Jews. History has balanced that. What Jesus, the single man, had to go in the hands of Jesus, in the hands of Jews, a single man had to be tormented in the hands of the entire community. Now, in the hands of a single person, the entire community had to go through the humiliation and all kinds of tortures had to go through. Existence balances itself. If you learn the art of balancing your energies, according to Chinese art of golden flower, it is known as anima and animus. You carry the traits of both within you. Sometimes the masculine energy or anima is dominating, the other times the feminine energy or animus dominates. And this is the way the tightrope walker walks on the rope and he balances himself, he does not fall. He leans to the left and to the right, and thus remains in the balance. When it is needed to use the aggressive energy, you display that. Now that energy is not using you, instead you are using it for being in the center, for being in the balance. There are times you use the negative energy. The two energies have become a great force in the hands of a person of awareness. That anger will not consume you, or the positive energy will not make you a utopia. There will remain a balance. Remember, anger is the downward movement of existential bioenergy. The bioenergy is one. When it moves upward, it has a different quality. When it moves downward, it has a different quality. It is known as anger. When this bioenergy manifests through the lower psychocentres, it breeds negativities. That's why when we look into the various centres, or according to psychoanalysis, or we use these as chakras according to Hindus, or latayas according to the Sufi terminology, when the energy continues to revolve in the lower centers, the earth center, the water center, the fire center, it creates negativities. That is why the emphasis of Sufis is on invoking the heart center of Kalb. Unless and until the heart center is invoked, the journey of transcendence is not possible. The Latayaf of the Kalb. This existential bioenergy, when it moves downward, it creates negativities. Without clearing such negativities, journey to higher realm is impossible. This existential bioenergy is given to you to first understand its purpose, why this energy has been given to you. To involve in wish fulfilling, or in involving in sex in myriad forms, but for what purpose? This existential bioenergy is given to you to first understand its purpose, understand the techniques to allow the upward journey in the process of upward movement like descent. You attain not only fulfillment through sex, institute transcendent as well. And it is a great benediction when you transcend sex. I am not talking about suppressing. One day you was born through sex, the male-female interaction, and through that interaction, one day you transcend beyond. One day you come into life through the functioning of this energy through sex center, and through this sex center as well you transcend beyond sex one day. You attain inner harmony at physical, emotional and intellectual level. What a benediction. Without such an understanding and balance between physical, emotional and intellectual level, harmony does not happen. And without harmony within, emotions play a devil's role. This is what is eternal devil. Devil is not outside. When Jesus was on the mount at the devil encouraged him to jump in the valley. It is said in the scriptures, it is written, if the Messiah, the Son of God, jumps from the cliff, angels will protect him in the battle, save him. Jesus could be tempted to test that he was balanced in his head. It is also written in the scriptures, do not test your trust unnecessarily. I know angels will be there waiting to support me, but why should I put him to test? Yes, when there is a problem comes in, that's a different issue. But purposely you are going to test your trust of God, which is not right. This is the reason my approach to transformation of human consciousness is not confined to any particular religious belief or anything. It is multidimensional. On a particular issue, I can speak from various dimensions so that people from all different belief systems, in your initial stages, someone belongs to a Hindu tradition, next one belongs to this tradition and that. I am coordinating, balancing, harmonizing all those traditions and bringing the cream of that which is needed for your transformation. Anger can be managed somehow. Management of anger is impossible without suppression. And anything suppressed gains strength, becomes a force impossible to reckon with. The first criteria is to understand this, and in that understanding itself, the process of dissolution of anger begins. A conscious catharsis is the sure way to dissolve anger. Many techniques are there for catharsis. However, this is an individual process. There are generalized techniques. However, individualized techniques are more effective. These are designed to suit the individual needs. Master penetrates your unconscious and subconscious layers and designs the techniques suitable for your growth and thus sets the process of transformation. For someone, zikr-e khafi may be useful. For someone else, a different device has to be used. One person used to come to the meditation. He had the problem that there was unpleasant upbringing because of his separation of his parents. He had so much of anger within for his mother, and he had suppressed the anger except the Islamic tradition, and then he had no money. He became more strict. The day he came to my office, I told him to listen to this particular meditation cassette. He came 8 o'clock in the morning when the office was opened. Until 4 o'clock he remained sitting down listening to this again and again. That kind of regimentation he had developed. That did not help him. He was wearing a particular kind of garb, carrying a stick in his hand. So I asked him, after many years, you don't like to wear normal clothes? He said, yes, I like. But I do not have money. The process went on, and one day I told him, in order for your process to continue, you have to consciously burn these clothes that you are wearing. You should burn these? No ways. I gave him some clothes and things which normally a young boy likes, the sneakers and clothes. But he still kept them. And one day he decided to burn them on his own. Whatever is being done, nothing was happening. His heart was hard like a rock. And when the heart is rock, hard like a rock, no zikrullah, no recitation, nothing can work. It is so hard, like a rock, nothing will do. A different process has to be devised. Then I told him one day, go to the meditation room upstairs. And I pointed out to him a particular corner. I said, this is the corner, focus, go on looking into this. And think that this is your mother. And go on cursing her. He said, cursing? I want to do meditation. I said, you do what I am asking you to do. And if you do not know the curse, I will teach you how to curse in many dimensions. This is part of catharsis. And he went one day, 2 days, 3 days. Few days it took. Notice that his heart is getting mellow, that suppressed anger is coming out in the form of catharsis. It is still at one point, it was stuck, it was not coming out completely. Then one day I gave him a knife. I said, this is the knife and the pillow gave him. I said, consider the pillow as your mother. Go and kill the mother in a symbolic form with this knife. Because the pillow is your mother and you are taking out all your anger onto the pillow and using the knife. He could not do it. That means the heart has attained to softness. The kalp got zakir. And also certain other things were given. So the process of catharsis is to be, there are generalized and there are individualized processes. Unless the master looks deep within you or prescribes the generalized or a group zikrullah, is not going to help enough for the transformation. Allow an understanding to dawn in you. The process of dissolution of anger will certainly begin. Understand anger. Allow it to dissolve. And only this much from now.